If you're not doing this one thing, then you may have trouble hitting your fitness goal. And this one thing can make or break you. It really can. It's that important. And that's what we're talking about in today's episode. So strap in and get ready for episode 036. Let's go.
I've always been that skinny guy.
Why can't I gain muscle mass?
What do I do in the gym?
They said I'd always be skinny.
This is your complete source for how to gain lean muscle and break out of your skinny body. From nutrition to getting the most out of your workouts and everything in between. We know just how frustrating gaining muscle mass can be. But don't worry, we've got you covered. You're listening to the Bones to Bulk podcast. So one thing that can make or break you, what in the world am I talking about? I'm talking about food prep. I'm talking about hacks to improve your food prepping skills and why, if you're not food prepping, you need to be. But before I dive into that, big news, the new workout program, The Resistance, that's right, The Resistance is out. So what that means for you is that is a complete at-home workout course. You don't need any equipment for, well, you kind of need one small piece of equipment that you can pick up anywhere for less than $30. But other than that, it's how to get strong, how to get buff, if you don't have time to go to the gym, if you don't have a home gym. So again, check that out. You can go to bonestobulk.com, see a trailer for it, and find out more about that. With that being said, let's dive in. So you may have heard of food prep. You may have doubts about it. You may be wondering, what in the world should I be doing with food prep? And should I be food prepping? I hear it's important, but is it? It absolutely is. And here's why. Life is crazy. We are all busy. We all have a million things going on. And when we fail to food prep, we're really setting ourselves up for failure. We're setting ourselves up to fall short. Because what's going to happen is there will be days when you, let's say, sleep through the snooze, or you have a crisis with the kids, or something is going to happen to where you don't have time to go in and cook your lunch or your dinner or prep your breakfast or whatever meal it may be. So you've got to hone in and focus on your food, because food is everything when it comes to hitting your fitness goals. It truly is. It's like 80% of the battle. I say that all the time. So what you want to focus on is your meal prep, and it's really easy to do. It's not this super complicated thing that has to be drawn out over days and days, and the more you do it, the easier it gets. So, make a list of everything you typically eat. Go to the grocery store and buy your groceries for the week. Then, as soon as you get home, or you can do it a different day, just dedicate a solid 3 or 4 hours to doing everything. I buy those disposable aluminum foil trays to where I can kind of cook everything, throw it in there, and then throw it in the freezer or the refrigerator. So I don't even have any cleanup. And what you want to do is you want to pre-cook all your chicken, your turkey, your fish, whatever lean meat you're eating, you know, pre-cook it all so that it's all ready to go. Then cook your complex carbs. So whether it's, you know, brown rice or sweet potatoes, red potatoes, whether it's quinoa, you know, cook all that ahead of time as well. Then you want to focus on your veggies. So cook up your veggies. And basically then what you're going to do is you're going to proportion everything. So, you know, you'll take some meat, you'll take a complex carb, you'll take some veggies, and you'll compile it however that may be. Maybe it's in a healthy casserole. Maybe it's just like that where you're not adding anything to it. It's just each item by itself. And add, sprinkle some spices on it, throw it in a plastic container, or again, one of those aluminum foil trays, throw it in the freezer, and that meal is done. You don't have to think about it. And it's the same thing for your lunches. And what I really suggest you do with your lunches is get a bunch of the plastic containers, whatever kind you want, and proportion it all out for every day on lunch. Especially if you're not home for lunch and you're at work, you've got to do this. So get all your food in a container so that each day all you have to do is open the refrigerator, grab that container, put it in your lunch bag, and go. This is crucial. I can't tell you how much this is going to, A, save you time, because when you have to cook every day, it takes a lot of time. It does.
Two, it's going to save you money because when you plan out your food, you spend so much less and you're not, you know, running through a drive-through or picking up fast food from or going to a restaurant, which so that's going to save you a ton of money. And three, it's going to keep you on track. When you're eating right, you kind of can coast. Has it ever happened where you're doing good with your fitness, everything's cruising along really nicely, and then you have a crazy day and you eat like crap all day long, and you feel like it takes you a week to get back on track? Like, that happens. That's real. So to avoid that, focus on your meal prep. Some other things you can do: chop up all your veggies in advance. And I'm talking like raw veggies. Like, maybe you do salads or fruit salads. Cut all that stuff up. Get it cut up. Put it in containers according to its type. And again, that's just a time saver thing. For your snacks, let's say you do almonds or smoothies or whatever it may be, you know, get Ziplocs, get the small little snack containers and measure it out, proportion it all out for each day. Again, I can't tell you, like, this stuff is so easy when you do it in bulk. You know, you have everything laid out and all your containers laid out, and you put it in this container, you put it in this container, you put it in this container, and you're done. You don't have to think about food for the rest of the week. You know that you're golden, that you're taken care of, that you're solid. So if you're not food prepping, I really encourage you to do so. Now, I'm going to share with you a couple quick little things that I like to make personally that may be a good idea for you. So fajitas, we love Mexican food in this family, like can devour it every day, all day. So, and you know that that's typically not a healthy food. So what we do is we cook up chicken and we saute up some onions and some bell peppers. Then once that's done, we add some brown rice or some beans. It depends on the week. And then we kind of mix it all up, add some seasoning, some spices, and we make enough usually for two nights. And then we'll put it all in one of those aluminum foil trays and we'll throw it in the freezer. So then all we have to do, and we have our, you know, our lettuce and our tomato and that sort of stuff already cut up. So literally all we have to do is throw that in the oven, let it heat up, warm up some whole wheat tortillas, and then pull out some already cut veggies from the fridge. And we're ready to eat with maybe 5 minutes of prep work. So it's something so easy and really good that you can do. Another thing we like to do is a chicken, potato, and veggie kind of casserole mixture. And again, it's, you know, we'll cook everything, we'll throw it all in a aluminum foil tray, and then we'll add seasoning, spices, and we'll throw it in the freezer. And that way, all we have to do, pull it out, throw it in the oven. Chili is another great item. If you're not making healthy chili, go buy some ground turkey and brown it up, add a can of crushed tomatoes, like the big can of crushed tomatoes. Then put in a bunch of beans of whatever kind you like, a can of corn, cut up some onion, add some chili powder, and voila, you have a healthy, hearty chili. I'm telling you, we eat the crap out of some chili. My daughter, that's like her favorite thing. And getting that kid to eat healthy food is like pulling teeth sometimes, let me tell you. So I hope this helps just kind of get your mind around some ideas and gets the juices flowing for A, why you need to be food prepping and how to food prep. And I'm telling you, make it a fun event. You know, my wife and I will do it together. We'll turn on some music and just kind of have at it. And it's not a miserable time. It's actually enjoyable because we know we're setting ourselves up for success for the week. With that being said, remember, no matter what anybody has told you, no matter what hurdles are in your way, what obstacles stand looming over you, you can accomplish them. You can get through it. You can reach your fitness goals. You've got this.